Faith is the confidence that what we hope for will actually happen. It gives us assurance about things we cannot see. Through their faith, the people in days of old earned a good reputation. Bible commentator David Guzik explains faith like this. Just as our physical eyesight is the sense that gives us the evidence in the material world, faith is the sense that gives us evidence in the invisible, spiritual world. If you have the substance before you, or you can see it, there's no use in faith. Faith is needed for what we cannot see, for things that we can't touch. In Hebrews chapter 11, we're given many great examples of faith. People in days of old, verse 1 says, who did things by faith that looked, felt, and by all practical means were impossible to accomplish. Here are just a few. There was Abel, who by faith brought a more acceptable sacrifice than his brother Cain did. Enoch, who was taken up into heaven without dying because his faith pleased God. And Noah, who built a large boat to save his family from the flood because he believed God, because he had great faith in God. But listen closely to what the Bible says, beginning in verse 13. All these people died still believing what God had promised them. They did not receive what was promised, but they saw it all from a distance, and they welcomed it. They agreed that they were foreigners and nomads here on the earth. What's all this mean to you and I today? We should live today in absolute certainty that God is faithful to His promises. We don't have to see them, experience them, or even feel them in this life to know that they are true. We can be sure of His faithfulness by what He's already done. So my hope for you and I today is that we'll live our lives in faith, believing those things that God has promised. He has shown Himself faithful. So let's live together by faith.